Is too much thermal paste really an issue? Many of you think so, or at least some of you who have watched my videos pertaining to thermal paste application do. It seems to be a pervasive sentiment that at least some people share. It's this myth that, well, maybe there's some merit to it, but we're gonna look at what it is exactly. So what is the theoretical issue? It's that the excess thermal paste, which is between the IHS and the cooler, and pushed out beyond the edges of the IHS, is insulating heat and reducing the efficiency of thermal transfer between the CPU and cooler when compared to applying as little as possible, which is a whole nother thing in its own right. So for the sake of science, once again, I want to test this out for myself. The test is simple enough. Is more thermal paste hotter? I'll conduct four series of tests, starting from what I would consider to be not enough paste, progressing to too much paste, way too much paste, using my go-to, this chonky tube of Noctua NTH2. And for fun, as usual, I added a bonus test, which we'll get to after going through results of the first four series of tests. Each test series will go as follows. Starting up the machine, allow it to warm up for 30 minutes, then begin taking a CPU temp for a period of 15 minutes to get an idle reading. Next, a gaming benchmark, and after testing a few games in my library, I found that Horizon Zero Dawn ranked the highest when it came to CPU usage at around 30%. So for testing's sake, I let Aloy run around in circles for 30 minutes to get an average reading. And for the third and final test in the series is a synthetic benchmark using Cinebench R23. The test is about 10 minutes long, and it pushes the CPU to its limits. I'm not going to go through my whole machine, but here's a list of all the components. The most important one, I think, is the AIO in this case, and I set the fans to a constant 50%. So for the first test, I applied, in my opinion, too little thermal paste. It's the tiny pea method, if you will. And as for coverage, it managed to cover roughly 60 to 70% of the IHS. It's not the worst coverage. I've definitely done tests where I put less on, and I don't think that this is like a detrimentally small amount of paste. It's not terrible. But anyways, the results. Idle, average of 31.8 degrees Celsius, Horizon Zero Dawn at 61.4, and Cinebench at 71.6. Now these numbers don't really mean anything yet, but they're gonna be our baseline. So right on to test number two. About the right amount. Using the P method, although after testing, it looks like I put a bit too much on there, and there's some spillage around the sides, but overall, I think it's fine. The results, idle, down 1.4 degrees from the last at 30.4. Gaming benchmark up about a half degree at 61.9, and Cinebench down to 68.9. Not completely insignificant changes, particularly the 2.5 degrees difference between the Cinebench temps, but we're gonna have to see more of these results to get an idea of any trends. And that leads us to test number three. Too much paste. So I plunged the syringe until I felt an unease at the prospect of having to clean up the excess thermal paste, creating a mess or worse. And as for the spread, it of course covered pretty well the entire IHS, with the extra paste leaving a small mess to clean up. And looking at the copper plate on the AIO, you get an idea of how much wasted paste there is. For the scores, idle up slightly from the previous test at 31.2 degrees, Horizon Zero Dawn at 62.1, and Cinebench at 69.5. Now at this point, although minor, there is some evidence to the claim that too much thermal paste insulates, as we see an overall upward trend in the average temps. But let's take it one step further with test number four. Way too much thermal paste. And this time I laid it on, not like Steve from Gamers Nexus Insanity, you know that one video where he emptied like an entire tube on the CPU or was in the socket or something like that. Yeah, not like that, but like normal people insane. Like I actually have to use this computer for like editing this video you're watching right now or gaming or doing anything really that I want. So I can't destroy the thing, but I put an uncomfortable amount on there. At least for me, it was way too much. And it only became more evident that I put way too much on there the moment I tried to take the cooler off, because I couldn't, like it wouldn't budge. I tried for minutes trying to remove the cooler with no success. So I booted up the PC again. The CPU cooler, it held on. It was like cemented on to the CPU. I had no screws attached on. It was just on there by the suction force of that CPU paste. So I ran Cinebench again in hopes of heating up the paste to loosen the grip, but It barely helped because it still took me several minutes of careful twisting and pulling to safely remove the cooler. And of course, what was below that was another mess, though this time it seemed like most of the paste was actually around the IHS, not so much on the copper plate of the AIO, so it didn't like droop down and make it so much of a mess, but you could tell there was just way too much thermal paste around there, and it was certainly a mess to clean up. But anyways, we'll get to the results here. So idle was 30.9 degrees, gaming was 61.5, and Cinebench 68.6. Overall, did not continue in an upward trend. In fact, lower in all three tests from the previous, and even clocking the lowest in the Cinebench tests thus far. But at the end of the day, looking at this, these graphs or these charts, whatever I decide to make after doing this recording, this video, is that they all came very close to each other, within margin of error for the most part. And I suspect if I ran these tests multiple times without changing the pace between the tests, we would likely get different results anyways. And if I were to draw any conclusions from this, it's that one, too little was a bit warmer overall, though the spread was actually decent. It wasn't terrible. Number two, no, just no. Too much thermal paste doesn't meaningfully, keyword there, meaningfully insulate or create any noticeable issues when it comes to CPU cooling, at least not with modern CPUs, which are fitted with a quality IHS. How that fares over the long term, not really sure. That being said, there is some bad. So I got 3 points that I kind of thought of that are definitely something why you wouldn't want to do this. Number one, it's a waste of thermal paste. And I know what you're saying, it's cheap, but let's talk really. Is it really cheap? It's cheap on the surface, but imagine this. You head over to your LFCS, that's your local friendly computer store, to get some paste, and you succeed. You come home with some brand new thermal paste, but also a brand new 6900 XT because hey, they actually had them in stock and you really wanted to benchmark them in games against your 3080 Ti. But 4 weeks later, your wife sees the credit card bill, and having dealt with your PC addicted ass for 8 long years, she finally decides enough is enough, packs her bags, takes the kids, leaving you to attend custody hearings on a bi-weekly basis, only to come home where you find yourself at the bottom of a bottle wondering where it all went wrong. Now I want you to think about that the next time you dare utter the phrase, but Nick, thermal paste is cheap. Number two, it's messy. You don't want to have to mop up paste off your motherboard. It's just not fun. It's a waste of time. And number three, as my experience has shown, it makes it bloody difficult to remove the cooler on occasion. And honestly, you don't want to have the stress of trying to remove your cooler without ripping out your $700 CPU from the socket. But anyways, I did say that I had a bonus test, which of course is to use the buttered toast method, because I know what will happen if I don't. The comments come flooding in, even though, at least for me, I've adequately debunked the does application method matter debate. I spent several minutes trying my best to get the perfect spread, even going as far as to remove my GPU and cooler standoffs so that I could give myself the best angle of attack. But even after that, the final product was fine, I guess. I added a teeny tiny dot in the middle to ensure good coverage. As for the results, not bad. Idle middling at 31.2. However, both the gaming and synthetic benchmarks come in the lowest, with the Horizon test 0.2 below the pack at 61.2, and the Cinebench temp only 0.1 below the lowest at 68.5, which happens to be the way too much paste test. Take a good look at these numbers and draw your own conclusions, but seriously, look at them. What do you think? What do you think? What do I think? Well, save any long-term changes that may occur, that extra thermal paste may dry out around the sides of the CPU, creating an insulary effect, but without any data or the means to test this myself, I can't say one way or the other. So as with other tests I've done, it's really the same. Like, I don't think it really matters that much. Personally, I'm not gonna chase tenths of a degree. I'm gonna eyeball a dollop that looks about right to me and call it a day, because the differences are barely enough to even be worthy of the name. In fact, I'm actually impressed at how close they ended up being in the end. Not even 1 degree difference between Horizon Zero Dawn tests. That's what I think. Let me know what your take is. Tell me if I messed up. I'm here to learn as well. And to close out this video, I'd like to read a comment in reply to using too much thermal paste on one of my other videos. It's from Pickle A Day Keeps the Doctor Away. And I think they basically have it right, at least the first part of their comment. And it's that it's hard to have too much, but it's easy to have too little. Use a bit too much, it's messier. use too little, you're going to have a bad time. But anyways, my name is Nick. This has been Tech Illiterate. Thanks for watching. There we go. Let's do it. It's too much pit. It's too much paste. Here we go. All right. Number two, no. Before weeks later, your wife sees the... Before weeks later, your wife... I got this.